Hello there, people. We are going to talk a little bit about RAM. And we have all heard this little notion that 8 gigabytes on Apple is the same as 16 gigabytes on Windows. So why is that? Well, I'm not going to say that that's 100% truth. There's a little bit of marketing bullshit onto it. But it's also not really totally massively wrong, because there is a lot of factors that plays into how RAM is being used and how much you need depending on how the OS handles it. So you have to think about it all depends on the OS. So have this in your mind. So let's say this over here, this is like 16 and this is 8. So things that both of these do, they have something called paging. Linux called it swap. That's just a nickname. Linux don't do swapping, they do paging. Go look at the description and explanation from the developer that handles paging under Linux, and they say themselves in the man pages that it's called paging, but they just call it swapping internally. Then there's also caching. And again, I'm dyslexic, so bear with me. I think this is how you spell caching. Then there's also compressed. Let's call it compressed. And there's a lot more, but these are kind of the simple, you know, this is something almost everyone understands these things. And by the way, this is like a high level view on it, not going into crazy details. Think about these technologies are some of the main technologies that computers use to handle RAM. You know, they use paging if we run out of physical memory. They use caching, they use compression. And some of these things here, like compression and stuff, that also is going on inside the RAM themselves. So why do Apple say that 8 gigabytes may be the same as 16 or close to 16 on the Windows? Well, it's all about efficiency, the good old EF. Let's call it efficiency. You think about efficiency. Again, it's not totally like this, but think about it a little bit like, you know, you have a lot of workers. Those are the people. Those are the people that are going to take small little packages. And these small little packages are your bits and bobs. They're going to put them into the RAM mod. The more efficient these people are to do that job, the more efficient they are, the faster they can do it. And then you technically need less RAM. Let me explain a little bit. Imagine when I'm saying putting things in and out or doing work inside the RAM, you're talking about people that are working in a certain speed. So if they are not working that fast, so let's call them slow. I think we will call them slow. Slow and fast. So these people up here, they are really slow to take things in and out of memory. They're really slow in compressing things within memory. They have to move them to some part of the memory, then they have to put them into boxes and compressing them. They're really slow at it. And if you're having a lot of programs running on your computer, well, because they are slow in quotes, well, they can't keep up. So this is basically a little bit like a buffer zone. Same down here. So here you have a 16 gigabytes buffer zone, and here you have an 18 gigabyte buffer zone. So because these workers here over here are a little bit slow, by doing all of the works, taking things in and out of memory, compressing it, putting it into the paging file, taking out the paging file, and blah, blah, this is basically the OS handling this. For you to not get into memory issues, you give them a lot of headroom. You give them a lot of buffer. So while these workers are compressing some things and doing some things, other workers can put more things into it. If you have fast workers that are really fast at putting things in and out of memory, compressing things, putting it into the page file, you don't need that big of a buffer zone. When they say 8 gigabyte is the same as 16, what they mean is they can handle the same workload. They can handle the same work. That's really what they mean. And that is because their workers here, these little champs here, little aliens, robots here, they are really, really fast, efficient. For every task that they do up here, they may do it 2 times. So they are 2 times faster at taking stuff in and out of memory, compressing it, putting it into page file, taking it out again. So they don't need as much as a buffer zone before things gets out of hand. That also means that you will probably use more paging down here. You will use more caching down here. You will use more compressed memory down here. That in and of itself is not bad. The OS up here look intelligently at and are really good at it on the Apple side, and also the Linux side for that matter, or any Unix-like system, to say what do we put into caching, what do we put into what memory do we compress, and what memory do we put into paging? So it's basically like being really smart. It has like, look at it a little bit like it has a higher IQ than Windows have about what these workers down here are doing. It's better at managing these workers here, so they can do their job more efficiently. They're not putting the wrong programs or data into compressing, caching, and paging. And they know that, it's probably not a good idea to put, you know, the program we just opened up and put all of that into, you know, a compressed file and stuff like that, even though some of the bits and bobs probably will be doing anyway, and both operating systems do it. Again, this is a really complicated thing, and you have to understand a lot of the basics about all of these things that I'm talking about here. You also have to understand the basis of how the kernel in the OS is handling these tasks and stuff like that. The thing with memory is it's not as easy in the 1990s to like 2000 and let's say 8 more equals better. This was the universal truth. People are still stuck in that mindset because nobody talks about that, Windows has gotten way better at optimizing the RAM usage. Linux has gotten way better at optimizing RAM usage. macOS has gotten way better at optimizing RAM units. And how kind of like one of the things that they're doing that, or how they're doing it, is you hear about this unified memory. That basically means that if you have like the CPU here, let's say this is a memory module and this is a memory module, they are really close to each other. They're really good at talking. Like there's almost no latency talking to the CPU and the controllers and blah, 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 blah. That's why they are faster. Where on a traditional Linux machine or Windows machine, you know, you have your CPU here and then you have your motherboard and then you have your RAM sticks all the way over here. I know this is like highly simplified, but they have to go through lanes and stuff like that underneath the motherboard in a PCP lane to talk to each other. Where on Apple, this is more or less built into one chip. That's why it's called system on a chip. So they have RAM there, they have GPU there, and because everything is in one package, it cuts down on, or it amps up the efficiency. They become faster, they become better, there's not so much latency. So they need less resources to do the same work. And that is basically what this 18 gigabyte or 8 gigabytes equals 16 on comes from. You have a modern motherboard here. You have the CPU socket, you have the RAM sockets, and then you have the fastest graphic cards or the fastest PCI slots are the closest one to the CPU because of efficiency. This down here is almost, I don't think I ever seen the lowest part of the lowest PCI lane or PCI slot on a motherboard being the fastest. It's always, this is the fastest, this is equally as fast, and then this is probably half the speed, a third, and blah, 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 because latency. And it's, the communication has to go from here to here, here to here, here to here. That takes time. It's the same with the RAM modules. If you look at them, they are really close to the CPU, and that is because of efficiency. If something is more efficient, you need less of the same thing. I will say that people that say, I can definitely feel the difference running, let's say, macOS with 8 gig and Windows with 16 gig. I can definitely feel the difference doing what I'm doing. 9 out of 10 times, I will call bullshit because you can. It's all placebo effects. I will almost guess that most people, will not feel the difference between 8 and 16 gigs on Windows or Linux. That's how stupid this debate is. Most people will not notice a difference. The people that probably will notice a difference are creative people, coders, you know, 3D artists, 3D people, math people. These people here, audiophiles, you know, go under creative people, you know, artists, content creators and stuff like that, coders that do massive amount of big programs that have compilers running while they also have, you know, web browsers open, reading Stack Overflow and all that fucking things. And then, you know, render people do, you know, 3D animations and blah, blah, blah. People that are doing massive fucking math equations and algorithms and stuff like that. They will probably know it because you need a lot of temp, you need a lot of temp storage here. But 99% of the people bitching and moaning about, I definitely need 16 gig, you don't. I have used 8 gigs of RAM up till 3 years ago when I actually started this channel here. My gaming channel is linked in my on this YouTube channel. I ran a gaming channel for 7 years on 8 gigs of RAM, and that means recording, editing, streaming, and blah, 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 blah. The only time I noticed that I went from 8 to 16 and then to 32 gigs of RAM, you know when I'm noticing it? Editing. That's the only place I noticed that I have more RAM. I could take, I have two 16 gigs sticks in my new computer. I could happily take one of those sticks out, and I will not feel any fucking problems whatsoever with the things I'm doing. Maybe a tiny bit in game, I may lose like 5 frames per second in some games. But that's it. Most people that bitch and moan about RAM don't understand RAM. They don't understand operating system. And they don't know what they're talking about because it's they're building it up in their head. That, oh, this person said I need it, therefore I need it. You really don't. Look, you know when you need more RAM, your operating system becomes almost unusable. Then you know that either I need more RAM or faster CPU. And if it's because you have like 10,000 Pornhub and Chatterbait windows open, you need more RAM. You know when you need more RAM. 16 gig is probably the sweet spot. It's probably where, you can do most things to, you don't have to think about it for, a couple of years. I will say that with Apple's 8 gig, in a few years, that will probably, it probably has to go up. Like in 3 or 4 years, yeah, we probably need to base that up to 16. With how big programs are becoming and how more and more people are buying entry-level Mac products to basically do creative work and coding and stuff like that. There are so many tests out there where they test Python, Java, C++, front-end, back-end development, gaming and what have you not on an 8 gigs and 16 and whatever the next step is. I hope this made a little bit of fucking sense. It has all to do with efficiency. It has all to do with hardware design. It has all to do with how the OS handles it. See you all later. Bye-bye.